our past park president and also the area B4 governor. He's saying that his learning philosophy is to learn from the best and to be the best. You want to take this opportunity to thanks to a supportive and positive group of people. And he's saying that he has been quite some time not speaking since last year's December. So today is his first skill of speaking share with us. And he welcomed the audience to give feedback for after his speech. So basically today, can we be doing the advanced manual speaking to inform? Number 3 is demonstration part. So let's welcome our general director to give the notes to our Liberator Innovation in GCF.
Dear Advanced Communicator Goal Competent Leader Lee Wei Xiong, your notes are: the purpose for this talk is for the speaker to present a demonstration talk of 5 to 7 minutes on a process, product or activity. The speaker may use body language, an actual object or a model for the demonstration. The speech delivered without notes should keep the audience interested, and each segment in a demonstration should be explained clearly and specifically. In addition to your oral evaluation, please write your evaluation in the mail. Thank you.
Okay, tonight, Kevin Lim is sharing with us the topic, the naked skin. The naked skin, Kevin Lim.
I assure you, the full Monty will not happen here nor anywhere in this world. Though the special body needs me. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, good evening.
Good evening.
The skin is one of the God-gifted gifts to us. Everyone has a skin. It doesn't matter how we take care of skin. But let's start with something basic for this day. The skin is one of the largest organs in our body. I'm showing you, when you stand full monkey in front of the mirror, it's one of the largest skin you can see, or a part of the organ. And the skin is basically has two functions, which is one, the function is to protect from external elements. Elements, for instance, like the bacteria, microorganisms, and others as well, that may attack our body. So imagine the skin is like the Great Wall of China to protect us. Then, next, it helps to regulate our body temperature. But in this room, some of you feel very cold, some of you very hot, because the skin helps to regulate temperature inside us. And lastly, the skin also helps to feel the touch, cold or heat, as I just mentioned earlier. But let's go back to basic again. If you remember back then in school, you will remember that there are 3 layers of the skin in our body. The first or outer layer is called the epidermis, as you can see. This is called the epidermis. But I mentioned earlier, the epidermis is the front liner of our body, or the organs, whereby it protects us from any external, say, elements that may enter into our body system. Otherwise, we will fall sick easily. And that is why people who got burned, they are advised not to go too near to them, because they may get infection very, very easily. And the bottom layer below the epidermis is called the dermis. The dermis is whereby in between the, or rather, is where you see the most of the nerve cells or the blood vessel will be. And that is why sometimes when you cut yourself, you may feel the pain, ouch, or blood is spilling out. It depends how deep your cut is. That is why when anyone has an accident, it's always important that the wound get healed very fast or quickly as much as possible, so that to avoid further infection that may perhaps cause the same death situation, so to speak. And the bottom part here, below the dermis, is the subcutaneous fatty tissue. The subcutaneous fatty tissue is the function is very important, which I mentioned earlier. It helps to regulate our body temperature. That is why fats is also important in our body. Without fats, we will feel cold or freeze like a frozen chicken. That's why fats, for this purpose, it helps us to produce sufficient heat in the event that we are cold. Go to cold countries or the Cameron Highlands or anywhere, so to speak. And of course, in the bottle itself, this particular fatty tissue is also like the main blood vessels. Now, let's move on. Between men and women, the skin is definitely different. I'll start with the first point, the main differences. There are many differences, but I'll start with one of the few. One of the issues is skin thicknessness. Guys, as you know that for us men, we have thick skins. Literally, we have thick skins because of our nature. Our testosterone give to us, we have thicker skin. Whereby, if you notice that as we grow older, the tendency also look like a trough or rather a very grumpy old man is quite unlikely because we don't have much wrinkles or fine lines. Unfortunately to the ladies, it's quite the reverse because your skin is much thinner than ours. That is why as you grow older, you will see more wrinkles. That's why most ladies will chase after the fountain of youth, which it never happened and it doesn't exist at all. So, kudos to us, 1 point. Nonetheless, the ladies also have another advantage, which is the second point. The subcutaneous glands are all pores. You see, for us, our body, we have a sweat gland or subcutaneous. Remember the gland, the subcutaneous gland, whereby for us men, we have a larger pores, and our glands is very active. In short, which means to say that our face for guys, we tend to have a very oily face most of the time. Whereas for the ladies, as they grow older, their oily faces become lesser, or rather, they become smaller and smaller. That's why you don't see much ladies have oily faces. So, which means to say that for us men, we tend to sweat a lot because of the sweat glands, and therefore, we tend to smell a lot if we don't wash ourselves thoroughly or clean ourselves. Now, to take care of our skin is very simple. All we have to do is to protect ourselves from the sun. That's why the ladies are very good at taking care of themselves from the sun. They have the umbrella. And God knows that maybe they use the banana boat protection and so on. Which is good because if they're exposed too long, too much under the sun, our skin will become fractured, will become dry, hydrated, more and so on. Next is if those of you who smoke too much or who those other smokers, I advise you to quit smoking as fast as possible. Because the more you smoke, there's a tendency that your blood vessel will have even thinner and lesser that go to your face. That is why people don't smoke, you see that rosy cheek much more nicer looking. And what's more, treat our skin gently, particularly us men, we tend to shave a lot, don't we? But if we shave every day, there's a tendency that we always grab our skin. It's just coming an apple all the time, the same spot again and again. So that is why for us men, if we shave too much or too often, we have to be very careful. We have to use aftershave lotion to get ourselves. Lastly, eat healthy diet is always important. Vegetables is always the essential. Keep us eating healthy all the time. So ladies and gentlemen, this is a short tips or advice we can take care of our skins. Hopefully that we can grow older gracefully. With that, thank you.